Hey guys, it's Alicia, and today I'm going to show you all the things using Elementor Forms. When you have a business website, forms are a staple. They make it easier for customers to get in contact with you, as well as provide important information and feedback. However, figuring out how to create them can be challenging. If you're looking for a simple, straightforward strategy, we recommend using Elementor Forms. This popular page builder provides solutions for building a variety of forms that are both aesthetically pleasing and easy to use. In this video, we'll walk you through the process of creating a form and then cover some helpful add-ons and troubleshooting tips. Of course, before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, how to create an Elementor contact form. Now that we understand more about why you might want to use Elementor Forms, let's take a look at how you can create one in a few simple steps. Note that for this tutorial, we'll assume you already have Elementor installed and activated on your website. There is a free tool and paid plugin. To access the form features, you'll need the premium version. To get started, navigate to the page or post where you want to insert your contact form. Then, click on the Edit with Elementor button at the top of the screen. This will launch the Elementor Editor interface. From the widgets on the left, search for and select the Form widget. Then, you can drag and drop the widget onto your page. This will insert a standard contact form. Once you place your contact form on the page, there are a handful of settings for you to configure. For now, let's focus on setting up the form fields. You can edit the basic form fields by clicking on the widget and customizing the text, if you want to change any of the default options. If you want to add additional fields, you can do so by selecting Add Item. You can select the type of field you want to add from the drop-down list. Next, you can add a label, which is the name of the form field. This shows your visitors what input is expected. For the placeholder option, you can customize the text that appears in the form field before the user enters their information. You can use this to give visitors examples of the data you want them to provide. Additionally, you can choose to enable the required setting and modify the column width. You can also click on the buttons panel to customize the appearance of your form buttons. You can change the sizing as well as the font and colors. After you're finished creating the form fields, the next step is to configure your form submission settings. You can navigate to email within the Elementor editor to access the variety of options. For example, you can input your email address in the To field where you want the submissions delivered. You can enter multiple email addresses if you wish. You can also customize the subject of the email and message. When you're done configuring all of the options, make sure to save your changes. If you want to further personalize your contact form, you can do so by enabling custom messages. Select additional options, then move the toggle switch for custom messaging to yes. There are four types of messages you can modify. Success message. This appears once a user submits the form. Error message. This will come up if there's an issue during the submission process. Required message. To inform users that a particular field wasn't completed, and invalid message, to let users know that something with the form submission is off. You can customize these messages to match your brand's voice and style. For example, you can modify the wording to add a bit of personality. Once you have the basic text and fields of your form taken care of, you can begin styling the design of your Elementor contact form. For example, you may want to make sure that it matches your branding. To get started, you can click on the Style tab at the top of the widget editor. Here, you'll find a wide variety of options and settings that you can use to customize the design of your contact form. For instance, you can adjust the spacing and padding, as well as change the colors, size, labels, and buttons. When you're satisfied with the look and contents of your Elementor contact form, the only thing left to do is to save and publish it. You can do so by selecting the Publish button at the bottom left side of the screen. And that's it. Then you can preview your contact form on the front end to confirm that it looks as you want it to. Out of the box, the Elementor Page Builder comes with plenty of options for building forms for your WordPress website. However, you might also consider adding plugins to help extend the functionality of your forms. Let's take a look at some options. The Master Add-ons for Elementor plugins is a freemium tool that provides a collection of helpful tools for enhancing the page builder and, in turn, your website. It's also compatible with a wide variety of form plugins. This includes Contact Form 7, Ninja Forms, WP Forms, and Caldera Forms. To access all the plugin's features, you'll need to purchase the Pro version, which at the time of filming this video was available for $39 per year. Another handy tool you can use with Elementor is Plus Add-ons. This plugin is packed with over 8,000 customization options and over 300 user interface blocks that can help you create and design your pages and forms with ease. Its features include icon boxes, map sections, forms, and pricing tables. There are also more than 18 templates you can choose from. These were designed specifically for certain types of businesses, including agencies, restaurants, salons, and more. There is a free version available. However, to leverage the entire suite of useful features, we recommend purchasing a premium license, which at the time of filming this video was available for $39 per year. If you want to create Elementor contact forms for your WordPress site without paying for a premium license, there are ways you can go about it. Doing so will require you to pair the page builder with another WordPress form plugin. Let's say you opt for Formidable Forms. Once you install and activate the plugin on your site, you can navigate to Formidable, then Forms, then Add New. Next, you can select Contact Form from the list of options and choose from a handful of pre-made templates. When you're done building your form, browse to the page you want to place it on and launch the Elementor Editor interface. From the left-hand panel, search for and select the Formidable Forms widget. You can adjust the format, colors, buttons, text, and more. When you're done, you can save and publish your changes. This method requires a bit more time and effort than would be necessary with the Elementor Pro plugin. However, it can help save you some money if you don't want to purchase a premium plan. How do you create forms in WordPress? Let us know in the comments section below. If you're looking to boost your site's organic traffic and beat out your competition, then we have the perfect ebook for you. Download our free Ultimate Guide to SEO ebook to gain access to the 50 plus tips we used to grow our own organic traffic by more than 123% year over year. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.